Hey everyone, King Size Customs.
Hey everyone.
The man right here. Alright, so basically what happened with this video was you'll hear some sound in the background. It's me recording. I got a new microphone, so the audio is a little bit better here. I don't have to overmodulate it, and then I also got a better editing program so I can actually edit my audio tracks down as I'm recording them or right after recording them. Just plop them right in, and then there we go. But, the other thing is, I tried to do it as I could just drive the truck and then sit and see if you guys could hear me. Unfortunately, that didn't work. So this is just a little bit of frustration. If you can hear the audio in there, it's fine. Otherwise, just take this as one of those little relaxing videos that you can see. For future videos, I'm just going to record truck driving and then record the audio track. So, anyway, on to the video.
But, anyway, so, what's nice is, it's a new year, new microphone. The audio will be a lot crisper, clearer, and I probably won't overmodulate, which, I don't know about you guys, but my loyal subscribers, viewers, followers, minions, whatever you want to refer to yourselves as, I'm sorry that you had to put up with all the overmodulation of my voice. There was nothing I could really do about it. So, here's hoping this helps. I'm still a terrible truck driver. Trashy YouTuber fame, but I'm not one of those YouTubers, so, but yeah, let me know how your holidays were going, how your new year is, what you hope to do with this new year. What I hope to do with my new year is just go back to just when I enjoyed life a little bit. Maybe it was because of the naivete, but I don't know. I still have my moments here and there where I do have really good moments where life seems really, really sweet, so. Heck, every day I'm behind the wheel of this truck, or this bad boy. It's always a good day. I'm still looking for employment. I just put in an application not that long ago, so waiting to hear back, but you guys all know with the job rush, you gotta just sit and wait. And as I've gotten older, I'm starting to notice the world around me, the world gets older. I'm not sure if that makes a lot of sense, but once I give you the explanation, it'll really make a lot more sense. So, basically, what happened to me was I used to live in kind of like a static frame of time almost. I know it's real trippy to think about what it was like. You know, everybody kind of looked the same, stayed the same, talked the same. And then this year, especially compared to last year, more of the people that I talked to have gotten mature. There's a little bit more uncertainty about the future, which, don't get me wrong, I get there's being a realist and there's being a pacifist. Most of the people are more realistic, pessimistic. Did I just make a mistake and say pacifists? That has nothing to do with what I mean. I mean pacifistic, but... ah. I don't think you guys watch me because I speak well. I think you guys watch to see what I'm doing truck-wise. Or maybe it is because I speak well, but anyway. Sorry about that. That was one of the biggest errors ever. Shoot. But no, it's people have been getting more realistic, and people's appearances have been changing. Maybe it's just that I'm at a point where my vision's better now, so that I notice it. It's strange to me, but it's... you go living in a world where, like, I visit relatives who I haven't seen in about a year, and people look totally different than how I remember. So, go figure. People also, the way they speak, the word choice, the ideas that they say are totally different than they used to be. Maybe that's just because I'm older now, and I actually have a full grip on what's going on. Who knows? It seems so odd to me. Now, also, too, I see a lot of other things where people have changed, and I've always noticed that I didn't live in... you know, I live in a static frame of mind or static time period, but friends of mine are associates or people from elementary school, who I talk about all the time, you know, my constant, constant measuring stick of people from school that, you know... anyway, but the real crux of it, the meat and potatoes of it, is they would all change. Like, everybody kind of grew up and they look a little bit different. Some people look the same or taller, you know, regular stuff like that. But you can still tell the face and the facial features, like the eyes, nose, mouth. And they're pretty much the same person they were. Personality, yeah, some people change. Some people are still who they were. Other people. Maybe they haven't changed really good necessarily, but it's just weird. Like, you know, of course, I remember a lot of these people from, like, let's say grade 3 if you're Canadian, third grade if you're from the US. So I guess that's primary school in the UK, and I guess. But anyway, you know, I remember these people being super, super young, and it's like, wait a minute, you guys are going to New York for New Year's Eve? What are your parents? Oh, yeah, that's right. You don't live with your parents anymore. You have an apartment and a driver's license. Thinking about starting families and have a career. It seems so odd. The other thing was, I'm not sure if I stated this or not, I was held back for a year, so most of my friends are about a year younger than me. And that's what makes it always seem a little odd to me, because I was a year older, so I got certain privileges that other people didn't get. But, I don't know. It's one of those things. And then the other thing is, some of you guys who know me from Instagram, maybe not. I've been commenting more and liking more people's photos on Instagram. And it's more just because I need to get back to doing that. How do people know that I've seen their photo if I don't leave a comment or drop a like, you know? You just don't know, so... so I've been making changes before the year started. Another thing is, this is, if you can see in the GPS, this is kind of a shorter video. So, it is moving. I'm thinking. I don't really know, I just started recording it. So, let's see what works. So. That it's still going up a 5% grade, so we're good. So, but yeah, it's just, it seems so strange to me that everybody that I used to think of as, like, young ones, people that I would, well, I don't want to sound too weird, but people that I would look out for because they were younger than me, people that I tried to jealously or vainly instill some of my older age wisdom, which really wasn't that much older age wisdom. I was only a year older than most of them, so it's just, it seems so different that people are doing a lot of things. Now the other thing too is, in another video, or previous video, I'd stated how, you know, everybody else kind of changed with their morals and ethics, maybe. Personality. Personal values, that's what I'm looking for. And then me, I kind of stayed the same with my personal values. That's kind of the main difference with me, but I don't know, when you think about it, it's weird. Did I grow up or did everybody else grow up? Have I stayed the same? Has everybody else changed? Did I change along with other people? Am I still who I used to be? And I know in my New Year's Eve video I talked about going back to who I used to be. And as I started this video off with the wanting to be happy. You know, there's a YouTuber I watch who stresses the PMA, positive mental attitude. And he says, you know, it's not all about being happy all the time. It's knowing that you're going to have bad days, but that the bad days are going to go. You know, good days will come again. So that's more or less what I mean. You know, I am kind of dark and grim sometimes. I'm sure you guys have noticed it in my videos. But I don't want to be like that. I want to be, you know, the positive fun guy. I want to be the guy that, you know, you take out to the party and he's the life of the party almost. Something like that. I believe this is my turn. Yeah, I believe so. Alright, how do you get yourself out of this one, Kevin? Oh boy. Let me get myself out of here real quick. You guys are coming along for the ride. Lord, give me 40 acres, because I can't drive. There's an old country western song about trucking, so probably in the 70s when the whole CB radio fad thing was popular. The other thing is, whatever happened to CB radios, why'd they go away? Was it just because there was newer mediums, other ways for people to communicate, like cell phones, instant messengers, texting and all that fun stuff? I'm not going to say I missed them, because I was never really around when CB radio was big in its heyday, but... Well, let me phrase it this way. I was not alive when CB radio was big. You know, I think the big thing for that type of deal was more or less instant messenger. You know, you had people who would instant message each other in chat rooms and stuff. That's going back for some of you younger guys. I can't see around that mirror. But that's going back for some of you young people back when Facebook wasn't a thing. When AOL was what everybody used for email. I still have an AOL account, believe it or not. I never check it. There's probably nothing but viruses in there. So, but yeah, you had to pay for email using America Online, which I didn't. I got a free subscription. And then you had to also sign up for AOL Instant Messenger, or AIM as the kids used to call it. And by kids, I mean my type of, my age people. So... still raining a little bit. But yeah, so I guess Instant Messenger was the thing. This was before like Facebook even was like I said, Facebook was a thing. I think it was Friendster was popular, but I didn't know about it. And then MySpace came in and killed Friendster, which was in my teens later. And then after Friendster was MySpace, I never had a MySpace. And then the big thing was Facebook, and everybody around my age had a Facebook when they were like 12 years old. And then there's me, 13 years old, no Facebook. I didn't even have a computer in my room. I thought I was hot and stuff because I had a TV in my room with an old Xbox. So, and it wasn't no, you know, 40-inch or whatever flat screen. It was an old tube with a, not tube, but, you know, one of the fat panel TVs, 20-incher. Alright, where is this place? Because now I'm just driving around in squares. Oh, could it be that I need to go here? And I stalled the truck. Shoot. Let's see. Do I have to go here? Yes. Alright. But yeah, people also were like, in my school were cool because they had cable or dish in their room. I didn't have cable, and at that time, my mom had taken my TV out of my room and my Xbox out of my room and put it in the living room. So, now that I think about it, that actually wasn't the worst thing. Probably was a better idea, but as a kid, you know, you get used to having Xbox or a video game in your room and a TV in your room. You kind of come to love it, but it really wasn't hurt my academic performance. So, and then when I moved in with my grandparents was when they started going to aerial TV to get converted. So I had a couple of channels in my room at my grandparents. See how bad we did. Yeah, not too bad. Alright guys, I bid you adieu, farewell. Sorry about no music. Sorry that the audio changes a little bit, but it's a lot clearer, I can guarantee you that. Here we go. I'll let you see how bad we did.